Hey, today I'm going to be sharing with you how to make these air-dry clay balls. It's a beautiful craft that will add to your home decor. You can store your jewelry in these, use them for anything you want. It's just a beautiful creative piece anyone can make. So let's just jump into it and let's make it together. So you're going to need a non-stick placemat, just a silicone one basically, air drying clay. Then we're going to need a rolling pin with craft knives. I'm using wooden and metal one, acrylic paints of any sorts, paint brushes of course, fine sandpaper, and on top of it we're going to need some varnish. I'm using gloss. You'll need bows of any sorts. We're going to use them as molds. And then we're going to need beaded chain, ball chains, artificial leaf of any sort, stamps, and our rolling pins that are engraved. Either way, I'll explain more later. Now we're going to start with our air drying clay. I'm going to take just a little piece of it. We want to make sure that the rest of the air drying clay is packaged up and put away because we don't want it to dry out. I'm then going to just knead it as well as I can so that it becomes softer and easier to work with. Otherwise, air drying clay can be quite stiff. I'm then going to use my rolling pin. Once again, you can use a glass bottle to just roll it, and we want to roll it to around 5 millimeters, or basically 1/5 of an inch thickness. If it's too thick, it's going to dry for too long. If it's too thin, it's basically gonna fall apart. I'm then going to use my carving knives and just roll around the little ball and take out my little shape. I'm then going to just place it inside the ball. Yes, we're going to use it as a mold to kind of shape it up into this little ball. You want to use your fingers to do that. Don't press too hard, otherwise your fingerprints will stay on the clay and we don't want that. Smooth out the edges with a little bit of water, not too much, and you'll see you get this beautiful shaped ball. We then want to repeat similar procedure with another piece of clay. I'm using a larger ball here. This time we're going to actually place it on the bottom side of the ball and shape around it. Once again, I'm going to use a little bit of water to smoothen out all the ridges because, you know, it will just make it a lot better. Don't use too much water because then it will just soften up too much. We then want to use our beaded chains to engrave into clay and create these beautiful ornaments or our little balls, just like that. And then you just want to cut out the ball shape just like before, basically a very similar procedure. We're just going to use different items to basically make them look a little more cute. I'm using a little bit of water to soften it up. Once again, placing it into my little ball, little plate, shaping it up, and here we go, we have it ready. I'm then going to use my fake plant. Make sure that whatever plant you're using, whether it's real or artificial, it has quite a bit of texture to it, otherwise it's not gonna really mark anything in the clay. So we do that and we just continue with a similar procedure to previous balls, and I'm just going to shape it all up again. I'm also using an engraved rolling pin to create beautiful ornaments. As you can see, it really is quite significant. If you can get one, please do, it will change the game for you. And now we're going to leave these little clay balls to dry for 2 days. If the air drying clay is a bit thicker than 1/5 of an inch, then it will have to actually dry for longer. So do take that into account when you're deciding how long you're going to take to dry these, but do make sure they're fully dry before the next step. Now we want to take our sandpaper and basically sand our balls as well as we can so they're smooth and have no ridges. You might want to get a little piece of it to get into those little corners so that for real our balls are looking good and smooth. I'm then going to just dust it off with brushes, with paper, kitchen towel, whatever you have. Make sure there's no dust left afterwards. And now, the best step ever. I'm going to actually get some acrylic paint. I'm using white one, and I'm just going to paint all over the plates. balls, whatever we call them. We want to actually cover them in two layers, so make sure each layer is dried up before the other, and then you know you can decorate, you can have fun with it. We used all these ornaments, you can use them to create a beautiful piece that really looks nice. Although actually this step is not necessary, you can have your balls just as simple as they were before, although I do like to paint them a little bit for that extra you know. Finally, I'm using acrylic gloss varnish to seal it all in. This is a protective layer for these little balls. You can use matte one as well, but I highly recommend doing this because actually these balls will serve you for longer if you do that. Otherwise, all the items you're going to use them with will interact with the clay and change the way it looks. So do not forget this last step. And once you're done, let it all dry and you're going to have a set of beautiful balls that look amazing in your bedroom, in your living room, wherever. For more crafts like this, please like this video and subscribe. Come to craftsyhacks.com for full tutorials for many more crafts like this. Either way, have a lovely day. Thank you for watching. Take care. And you know what? Bye-bye.